Good morning. Glad to have you join us by way of Facebook this resurrection morning. We're so grateful to be walking with the Lord, living for Him, knowing that He is alive today. Amen. I hope that this is a rich and a blessed day for you as you reflect back on our resurrected Savior. Amen. Praise God. We woke up this morning in Central Texas here with storms passing through. And today, as I look outside, the storm is past and the sun's shining. The Lord's blessed us with a beautiful day before us. And you know, the storm that the people have been going through for the past little while with this virus is kind of rocky right now, kind of stormy right now. But this too shall pass. And we have a Savior that's alive. He's on the throne. He's all powerful. And He knows where you're at and He knows what you're going through. And this morning, as you reflect upon His death, burial, and resurrection, let your faith arise and let something from the Lord be given unto you today. I do believe He's right there with you. And I do believe that He wants to minister to you today. Praise God. We don't have to fear or live in fear. We have a Savior that's alive, and He knows right where we're at. And so worship this morning with us as we are assembled. A few are here. The rest of you are in your homes. But Jesus is right there with you. And so draw near to Him today and let His message touch your soul. And worship with these as we start this service. Worship with these and let God touch you right there where you are at. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
chose to take his power.
Church, I want you to remember all of our church family. We have elders that are out there and they're having a difficult time. Sister Cooper, remember her in your prayer. Talk to her this morning. She was very weak in her body. We want to lift her up to the Lord, as well as the many others, again, that call this their home church. Lift them up to the Lord. Don't forget one another. Amen. Praise God. We are a people that, regardless if we see each other, we need to be mindful of each other. Amen. Lifting each other up to the Lord in prayer. We're in this together. Amen. Praise God. We also need to be praying for our nation and our lost world. A lot of things are going on. You know, this virus going on and all these things. Many people have been affected by it. And, you know, God has a way of turning bad things around for good. This virus is not a good thing, but there's a lot of people that have directed their attention to the Lord because of the troubles that are going on. You know, unfortunately, sometimes some people wouldn't pray if it wasn't for trouble coming into their lives. That's true. It shouldn't be that way, but unfortunately, sometimes it is. And a lot of people have turned to the Lord and began to seek His face. And we want God to touch their lives. Everybody needs to realize, whether it's a good time or whether it's bad times, we need Jesus in our lives. Amen. Only He can save. His message is going out today in a lot of different places throughout our world. The death, the burial, the resurrection of Jesus. Amen. And we want that message to touch lives.
Thank you.
Come on, the clouds we find.
Hallelujah.
Yes, in Jesus.
Hallelujah. Let's give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah, Lord, we love you today, God. Lord, you're worthy of the praise. Oh, God, we thank you for your love today. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. What a great and marvelous day it is. Amen, that we get to gather together in Jesus' name. Amen, we get to celebrate, amen, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen. If Jesus had not have resurrected, we would not have had life today. Amen. But I'm thankful today for this life and life everlasting that Jesus has promised unto us. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. I would like to thank everybody for joining in this broadcast today. Amen. I know that the Lord is going to bless you greatly. Amen. Don't allow the things of this life to trouble you and cause you to think that God is any less in control. God is in control today. Amen. Praise God. And I'm thankful today that He lives. Amen. He lives forever and ever. And because He lives, we too can live with Him. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. If you have your Bibles, I'd like for you to turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter number 15. 1 Corinthians chapter number 15 and verse number 12. Paul, writing to the church of Corinth, says, "Now if Christ be preached that he rose from the dead, how say some among you that there is no resurrection of the dead? But if there be no resurrection of the dead, then is Christ not risen? And if Christ be not risen, then our preaching is in vain, and your faith is also in vain. Yea, if we are found false witnesses of God, because we have testified of God that he raised up Christ, whom he raised not up, if so be the dead rise not. For if the dead rise not, then is not Christ raised. And if Christ be not raised, your faith is in vain. Ye are yet in your sins. Then they also which are fallen asleep in Christ are perished. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable." Amen. Before I begin this message today, I would like to thank everyone that participated and has helped. Brother Roland is running the camera in the back. Amen. And so that we can put this on YouTube later. And there are others here. Brother John came in to play, and Rachel, and Emily, and Danielle, and Dallas, and Brendan. Amen. My mother is running the camera. Amen. We are few in number here in this place today. Amen. But God is here. Amen. And God is in this place today because 2,000 years ago, he didn't stay in the grave. Amen. He didn't stay in the grave. He rose from the grave. Amen. Brothers and sisters, today, amen, we might find ourselves worried and troubled by this pandemic that is sweeping the world today. Amen. But can I tell you today that our hope for a better life is not in anything, it's not in stocking up with all the toilet paper. It's not in stocking up with all the eggs that you can eat. It's not in stocking up in all the groceries and all the amenities that you think that you could ever desire. That's not where your hope is today for. Amen. There's something far worse than running out of toilet paper. And there's something far worse than running out of eggs and other provisions. Amen. I realize that today, that in this world today, in this mindset, that people think that there's not much worse than that. Amen. But there is something worse, and it is this, that if there be no resurrection of the dead, then is Christ not risen. And if Christ be not risen, then our preaching is in vain, and your faith is also in vain. Amen. Praise God. If there is no resurrection of the dead, that's the worst thing that could ever happen to us today. You see, if there is no resurrection, there is no hope at all. Amen. No hope for a better here and now. And more importantly, no hope for a better, there and then. Amen. No hope for eternal life. Notice what Paul said, that if there is no resurrection from the dead, then our preaching is useless. Our faith is futile. Amen. Then sin is in control and Christ is dead. Amen. A man told his boss that he was called to be a preacher, and so he resigned his job. But he came back 2 weeks later asking for his old job back, and the boss said, "I thought you were called by God to preach." And the man said, "Yes, that was before the Lord heard me preach." Amen. It all means nothing if we hear and do not do. Amen. It all means preaching is in vain. Amen. If there is no resurrection. Amen. It all means that it all means nothing. Amen. If Jesus did not rise from the dead. Amen. All the preaching of the gospel of Jesus Christ is useless without the resurrection. Amen. If there is no resurrection, then faith is futile. Amen. Another pastor of a frontier church ended a stirring message with, "All those who want to go to heaven, put up your hands." Everybody enthusiastically raised their hands except for a grizzled old cowboy who'd been slouching against the doorpost at the back of the room. Amen. All heads turned as he sauntered up to the front, his spurs jangling, and said, "Preacher, that was too easy. How do you know if these folks are serious? I can guarantee to prove who really means it and who doesn't." The preacher says, "Okay, stranger, go ahead and put the faith of these good people to the test. Ask them anything that you want." At that, the old bristled cowboy pulled out his twin six-shooters and turned to the audience and said, "All right, who wants to go to heaven? Raise your hands." Amen. You see, our faith is in the Lord today, and that makes a difference in our lives. Amen. It makes a difference in what we do and how we live. And in our giving, amen, in our faithfulness to God, amen, because our hope and our faith is in Jesus Christ. Amen. We should not put our faith in the things of this world, in the things that are temporal, in the things that will come and go, in the things that will rust and run away. But we need to put our faith in Jesus Christ today. Amen. He is the reason for the season. He is in this day that we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen. It's such a powerful moment in history. Amen. Because from this moment on, no more did we have to remain dead in trespasses and sins. But we too can rise in newness of life because of Jesus, and because he did not stay in the grave.
Amen.
If there is no resurrection, then sin controls. One preacher announced that there were 726 different sins. What happened when he did that was that he was hounded for that list of sins by people who thought they were missing out on something. Amen. Some days it does seem like that sin controls, that sin gets the upper hand, especially in this world and in this generation that we live. We live in a very sinful generation. We live in a generation that espouses sin and advocates for ungodliness and wickedness. Amen. But there is still truth being historic generation because of the resurrection of Jesus.
Yes.
You see, if there was no resurrection, then Christ would still be dead. Do you believe in life after death? The boss asked one of his employees. Why, yes, sir, the new recruit replied. Well, then that makes everything just fine, the boss went on. Because after you left yesterday to go to your grandmother's funeral, she stopped by to see you. Amen. A singing group called The Resurrection was scheduled to sing at a church. When a snowstorm postponed the performance, the pastor had to change the outside sign to read, "The resurrection is postponed." What if the resurrection was postponed? No worse. What if there was no resurrection today? Amen. We would still be dead in our sins. We would not have life. We would not have the opportunity, amen, to live an eternal life with Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm thankful today for Jesus. I'm thankful that he died and he suffered on that old wooden cross. But I am most grateful today that on that third day he rose from the dead, because that allows me and you and everybody watching today this opportunity, this grand and awesome opportunity to live for Jesus, to have a difference made in our lives today.
Yeah.
Amen. Raymond Lindquist said that resurrection is our faith, what water is to the ocean, what stone is to the mountain, what blood is to your body. It is the first and last final word in the dictionary of God. It says that God is the author and the finisher of our faith.
Right.
Amen. Yeah. He didn't stay in the grave.
Right.
Amen. He didn't stay in the grave.
Right.
But he rose from the grave. We need to believe the biblical record. Amen. We need to understand that it's true. In Luke chapter 24, amen, we read this account in Luke in 24 and verse 1. It says, "Now upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared, and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee." Jesus has risen. He is the resurrection. He is that new life, that new birth that he wants to give unto you. Amen. He wants to give you that second chance. Amen. If you're watching today and you feel like that you have failed God and you have let God down, and maybe you have died in your spirits, and if there's no hope for you today, I'm preaching to you today that Jesus said that he is the resurrection and the life. He can restore you. He can renew you. He can bring you back to life. Amen. We read about the story of the prodigal son. Amen. The Bible says that a certain man had two sons. The younger son told his father and said, "Father, give me of my inheritance that I may go and do what I want with it. I want to spend it now. I don't want to wait until you die, but I want it now." And so the father divided up his inheritance between his boys. And the younger son went, and he went to a foreign country, and he wasted everything, the Bible says, on riotous living. And he ends up finding himself, after everything was gone, he finds himself hired out to a citizen in that foreign country. And he began to feed the pigs that this man owned. And the Bible says that he desired to even eat of the slop that the pigs ate. Amen. But there came a time in his life, amen, when this young man came to himself, and he said, "Things are better back at Father's house." And the Bible says that when he was yet a great way off, that Father, looking for him, saw him and ran and fell upon his neck. And notice the words of the Father. He said, "This, my son, was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found." Amen. That story signifies the call and the cry of the gospel of Jesus Christ to those who have walked away, to those who have died, amen, in the spirit, those who have went and fallen into sin. Jesus is calling you, and if you will turn your life around, if you'll repent of your sins, Jesus will fall upon you once again, and he will resurrect you to life. Amen. The Father said this, "My son was dead and is alive again." Amen. I feel in the Holy Ghost today that God is wanting and God is speaking to your heart. God is speaking to you. Amen. You have strayed away, but God is calling you. He's saying, "I don't want you to stay dead in your trespasses and sins, but I want to allow you to rise in newness of life. I want to resurrect you, even as Christ was resurrected on the third day." God still wants to resurrect you in the spirit today.
Amen.
Amen. It is an exciting time when we talk about the resurrection. Yes. And what it's all about. Amen. It's bringing forth life out of death. Amen. It is the empty tomb. A tomb that could not contain the God of the universe. That is now empty. It is the resurrection of Jesus that marks the promise of the kingdom resurrection for all those that believe and seek to serve the Lord. Amen. You see, without death, there cannot be a resurrection. Without the crucifixion, there could be no ultimate victory over sin and death. And Jesus shows us that the same is true in our lives today. Yeah, except a grain of wheat fall into the ground and die. Amen. It will not bring forth fruit. And except we die out to our sins, we repent of our sins, and we turn from them. We say, "God, we're not living like that anymore. You will never find that eternal life that you are seeking for. You will never find, amen, that longing and that feeling in your spirit, amen, to where something is missing. You will never find that if you never find yourself in an altar of repentance and you say, "God, forgive me of my sins. Lord, I turn from my sins. Lord, I want to die out to my sins. I'm not going to continue living that life of sin. But God, I want to turn around and I want to live for you."
Amen.
You see, the gospel of Jesus Christ is the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus. And then the act of Jesus coming and dying did not have to take place more than once. Moses got in trouble in the Old Testament because he smote the rock twice, when the second time God said to speak to it. Why? Because Moses broke a type. Moses was saying that Jesus had to be beaten more than once. Jesus had to suffer more than once for your sins. Amen. But Jesus, he only had to die once. And now we can speak to him. Now we can communicate with them. But I just say that you and I, we have got to live this gospel experience every day of our lives. We have got a sinful nature that if we do not live this gospel experience, it will rise up and it will take control of your life. And you will find yourself walking in sin. You'll find yourself doing things that you never thought that you would do. Amen. We have got to die out to our flesh. We have got to die out to sin every day. We have got to rise in newness of life every day. We need to be filled and full of the Holy Ghost. Every day we need to allow the Spirit of God to flow in our lives and to flow through us. every day we have got to pay the price. See, unless we first deal with the price that the resurrection cost, then it really becomes empty and meaningless. It is what theologians call cheap grace. For without facing the darkness and the death and bleakness, we travel through this valley of death. We travel through the shadow that hangs over us, fearing no evil, facing the agony of the cross and the tragedy of our own mistakes and our own transgressions, our imperfections, our sins. You see, without death, we have no sense of the price that was paid.
Amen.
See, the wages of sin is death. Jesus did not want you to die that eternal death. Everybody, it was appointed unto everybody to die. We were all born in sin and shaped in iniquity. You, me, everybody. We all had the wages of sin, which is death upon our lives. And when I speak of death, I speak of the eternal death. The eternal separation from God. But Jesus came. And he said, I'm going to bear on myself the sins of the whole world. I'm going to die that eternal death. So that you don't have to die. I'm going to give that ultimate gift. That I'm going to give my life. So you don't have to die in your sins. So you don't have to stay. And you don't have to live or die in that eternal death. But you can have the opportunity of life today. I'm thankful today for the sacrifice. Amen. Of Jesus Christ. Would have been meaningless had Jesus not have risen from the dead. It would have only done part of what needed to be done. In a sense, we would have only been able to repent, to die, and there wouldn't have been any other life that would take the place. There would not be a new life that would be placed into your life. But you see, today, because Jesus rose, because he resurrected on that third day, yeah. Amen, you and I, we have this opportunity.
Yes.
We have an opportunity today. Amen. Don't waste this opportunity. Amen. You may be far from God right now, but don't waste this opportunity. God is calling you today. God is reaching after you today. And he's saying, I want to restore you. I want to put new life inside of you. You may be dead in trespasses and sins, but I want to resurrect you in the spirit.
Amen.
See, we don't realize the immense value that God places on us until we look at the sacrifice that he gave. Psalms 51 describes how David, after falling into sin, he looked at his life and he saw himself as he truly was. See, this is a moment of his life, a place that each and every one of us has got to come to. You can't start blaming others for your sin. David didn't blame others. He didn't make excuses. He said, I know how bad I've been. My sins are staring me down. See, it's a concept that is called brokenness. And he recounts his life in Psalms. He has prayed and meditated and considered all the wrongs that he has committed, the ways that he had acted out of anger, the people he hurt. And he concludes that every time that he hurt others, he was walking all over God. He said, you're the one that I violated. And you've seen it all. You've seen the extent of my evil. Then he says, I've been out of step with you for a long time in the wrong since before I was born. Not that he was guilty as an infant of sin, but that somehow this potential was there and has been plaguing him throughout his entire life. that potential of sin is in each and every one of us today. Now David, he is willing to face it. He's willing to deal with it. But he's desperate for God to help him. He's willing to do whatever God wanted. He says, whatever you decide about me is fair. He says, scrub away my guilt. Soak my sins in your laundry. And then he says, soak me in your laundry and I will come out clean. Scrub me and I will be snow white. He knows that God wants what is best. But first he has to face the death and the darkness of his sin. Let me tell you, before you will ever experience this new life and this new opportunity of life, you must first acknowledge your sin. You must first repent of your sins. You must first die out to your sins and die out to your flesh. And allow the Lord to come in and change you. Amen. God wants. See, the resurrection is all about newness of life. God wants to have a Genesis week in your life where all things become new.
That's right.
Where a new world is spoken into existence. Amen. You may have hang-ups. You may have problems that you deal with every day. You may say, God, I don't know why you love me. I don't know why you're dealing with me. I just keep falling. I keep messing up. I keep falling by the wayside. Lord, I just keep straying. I keep doing things. I know what's right to do, but I keep doing the wrong things. I know what I should be doing, but I keep doing the wrong things. God, help me. I don't know how to move past this. I've come to preach to you in the Holy Ghost today that Jesus is calling for you to repent. Jesus is saying that even as I rose from the dead, I want to put that same new life inside of you. But he will not put the new wine into old bottles. You've got to repent. You've got to die out to your flesh. You've got to die out to sin today.
Yes.
It's important today,
yes.
Amen, that you die out to sin.
Yes.
You see, in Revelation, it talks about the saints of God. It depicts the millions of people worshiping God whose robes were pure white. They are faithful. They're the ones who follow Jesus. They follow the ways of God. They don't quit. They don't give up. They don't walk away from God or God's people. And here there's no more death, but resurrection. There's no tears, no suffering. These white robes, this is what we're looking forward to today. This is where our goal is, to make heaven our home today. These white robes were not new white robes that replaced soiled ones that were cast off. These robes aren't handed out like new pairs of white socks. They have been washed and cleaned by the blood of Jesus Christ. They have been made white by his blood. It was the sacrifice. Amen. That's the only way that your life becomes clean and your life becomes void and absent of the sins that you have committed. It's only through the blood of Jesus Christ. It's only because of the sacrifice that Jesus provided for you.
Yes.
That is the only way. But the robes were washed in his blood and they came out white again. They came out pure because of his death. Yet Jesus was raised on that third day. His resurrection promises us resurrection as well. The resurrection of Jesus promises us that we too, one day, will be resurrected. Today, you can experience that resurrection if you have not received the Holy Ghost. If you have not repented of your sins.
you can receive that resurrection today. If you will repent of your sins, and you'll be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. Amen. He promised to resurrect you. He promised to fill you with the Holy Ghost. He promised to give you that gift. He promised to put that new life inside of you. One day we'll have a new body, not like the old, but completely new. Free from the flaws and the defects of life. God doesn't just promise to restore us back to the original condition. You see, God promises to more than we can imagine. He says, I want to make you a new creation. I want to change you. I want to change that old nature of yours. And I want to put my nature inside of you. When the Lord fills you with the Holy Ghost, He's not just trying to dust up an old sinful man, but He's making you a new creation. He wants to do something great in your life. Before musicians can come. See, Resurrection Sunday is all about a fresh start. It's about a new lease on life, being born in a whole new way. This is your day today. Amen. If you have not experienced Jesus in this way, you need to experience. You're missing out. You need to experience the Lord today. Yes. Just because you're in your home, don't waste this moment. Don't waste this time. That God is calling you and saying, it's time for change. It's time for you to do things differently. It's time for you to repent of your sins. Quit living that way. And turn your life to me, and I will change you. I will put a new life inside of you. I will give you eternal life. Yes. Just as Christ died, was buried, and rose on the third day, you and I must live out this gospel message every day. Paul says, I have to die daily. Every day, I've got to live out this gospel. I've got to repent of my sins. Amen. I need the Lord to fill me full of the Holy Ghost. If you've never experienced Jesus before, again, I say to you, repent of your sins today. Turn from them. It's not just a mental assent that you believe in God, but it's an actual turning away from a life of sin. Repent. And be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, for the washing away of your sins. And He promised that you will rise in newness of life through the power of the Holy Ghost. And I close with John 11:25. Jesus looking at Mary and Martha after Lazarus has been in the grave for 4 days. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. I'm not just going to resurrect myself. But notice He extends it to all that believe in Him. He says, I'm the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Wherever you're at, in your living room, your car, wherever you're at, I want you to close your eyes right now. And I want you to talk to the Lord. Amen. We need the blood of Jesus Christ. If you've never experienced the blood of Jesus on your life, you need to repent today. You need to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. You need the Holy Ghost. God wants to resurrect you. He doesn't want you to stay dead in your trespasses and sins, but He wants to bring you to life. Amen. Cry out to the Lord right now. In the name of Jesus, God, I pray for you to touch your people. God, let the Holy Ghost, God, enter every living room. Lord, let the Holy Ghost, God, flow through every device. Let the Holy Ghost move and touch today. God, I don't want to waste this moment. God, you're calling me. I don't want to waste. God, the this moment that you have given me, this opportunity, Lord, to live for you, to rise in newness of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you for your sacrifice. I thank you for the blood. I thank you for your blood that you have shed for us. Oh, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Cry out to the Lord right now. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
The blood that Jesus shed for me to go.
Hallelujah. We pray and we hope today that you have been blessed and ministered to today by the worship and by the word of God. Amen. Don't let your heart fear in these, but have faith in God. Trust in the Lord today. Know that the Lord, He is in control. There's nothing that ever escapes His attention. Amen. And He lives today. And because He lives, amen, we don't have to worry about what we face tomorrow, because the Lord is in control. Amen. We here at CTC Belton, we want to wish everybody a very marvelous and happy Resurrection Sunday as we celebrate this our resurrected Savior. And if you have repented of your sins, if you want to be baptized, you are welcome to call 254-939-3464, as well as 254-831-3009, or you can contact us via our Facebook page. Amen. And we would love to baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. If you currently attend another apostolic church, amen, you need to be faithful to your own home church. Amen. And know that God is going to bless you. Amen. Stay faithful to God. Amen. And God, He will see you through and He will bless you. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, God, we thank you for your goodness today. Lord, thank you for your mercy and your grace. Dear Heavenly Father, I pray for you to bless your people. God, give us grace, God, in these times of uncertainty. In Jesus' name, thank you for what you have done for us. We love you and we thank you today. Be with your people, I pray. In Jesus' name. Everybody say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.